Après l'Amazonie, c'est maintenant l'Australie qui se consume. Vous avez toutes et tous vu ces images absolument terribles. Il faut agir. Il faut agir d'urgence. Sarah Hansen-Young est sénatrice écologiste d'Australie du Sud. Nous avons souhaité lui dire notre solidarité avec toutes les victimes en Australie et qu'elle témoigne de la catastrophe en cours. Sarah, est-ce que vous pouvez nous raconter ce qui se passe actuellement en Australie? Et notre première question, elle est évidente. Et vous, comment allez-vous?
Hi, thanks for talking to me. Obviously, down here in Australia, we're all exhausted and terrified of what's been going on in our country. Our nation's on fire. About twice the size of Belgium has been burnt here in Australia over the last two or three months, increasingly the last few weeks. We've lost thousands of homes, thousands and thousands of property have been destroyed, millions of hectares, and over a billion of Australia's native animals have been destroyed and perished in this fire. It is just heartbreaking and unthinkable. Unprecedented conditions. Of course, we've always had bushfires in Australia, but nothing like this. As the fire chiefs have warned, as scientists have warned, this is what climate change looks like. For us here in Australia, this extreme heat, the extreme drought, and now these incredibly devastating fires have made climate change front and centre of what we're experiencing here this summer. Well, of course, people are very angry about the lack of action and policy that the Australian government has had on climate change. We have a pro-coal government here, and it is driving a very slow response to climate change. Of course, we know around the rest of the world, Australia has been playing a pretty destructive role in international conversations and negotiations, and Australians are now sick and tired of it. They know clearly that these fires are climate fires. People have been rallying on the streets over the last few weeks. More and more Australians are getting louder and more angry and are demanding better action from their government. And the truth is that we have to transition from coal and from fossil fuels if we are to arrest any more of this dangerous global warming. We are already at 1%, 1 degree of warming. Our current government's policy would put us on track for 3 or 4%. Australians are increasingly getting angry about this, standing up and saying no. The Australian people are very, very thankful for the support that the Europeans have given us. Please continue to stand strong and demand that your government expect better from Australia's Prime Minister. We need encouragement to work globally. This is a global problem and we need your help now more than ever.
Nous pouvons agir, évidemment, à travers les politiques menées par l'Union européenne. Aucun État de l'Union européenne ne respecte aujourd'hui l'accord de Paris. Nous continuons, à travers nos entreprises, d'investir massivement dans les mines de charbon, y compris en Australie, et de mener une politique commerciale avec votre pays qui n'incite pas du tout à aider le climat. Et donc, nous devons d'abord agir chez nous pour pouvoir vous aider. Mais nous agissons aussi lorsque nous nous levons ensemble partout autour de la planète pour manifester à l'appel de Greta Thunberg ou d'autres à travers nos actions en justice que nous avons menées en France et que vous menez aussi en Australie et à travers le monde aussi en votant pour les écologistes. Ce combat-là, c'est celui que nous menons ensemble avec détermination. Nous sommes avec vous.